Hey y'all, it's Betsy from Cuttin Corners Vinyl in Nederland, Texas, and today is Craftmas episode 41, and we have a fun one for you. We went to Nutcracker Market a couple of weeks ago, and I saw everywhere Farmhouse Lazy Susans, and they wanted 60 bucks for them, so I was like, well, I can make one of those. So we're gonna show you how to do that today. Now, you're gonna need your Lazy Susan. This is a $10 Lazy Susan from IKEA. I've already pre-painted the base coat with the chalk paint, and this is in Simply White. And I think this one came from Michaels. You're also gonna need your vinyl, which I'm just using an old piece of Oracle 651 matte black. We're also gonna need the color to go over the top, which I am using the Deco Art Chalky Finish in Carbon. A brush, your Easy Weedin' wooden pick. We also have brown antique wax, so once it's dry, we can antique it, as well as your transfer tape. And I'm using the Gather file. This is available on our website, so go check that out. And if you'll give me a moment, I'll get the camera angle changed so you can see everything that we are going to do. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I've already masked and weeded this design, but this is more important about the paint technique than it is about the weeding of it. Plus, you've seen me weed things a gazillion times, or at least it feels like it. Okay, so now that is weeded. Kind of check for center. Actually, pretty good on my first try. And I let the chalk paint dry for about 48 hours from when I put the white chalk paint on before now I'm going to put the black paint on. Okay. So there we go. I don't know why I wadded that up. Okay, now we're shaking up. You want to make sure this is nice and mixed before you're working with any type of chalk paint. Okay. It's like, is that paint on my hand? No, it's not. Okay. So, just get your brush, which I'm using a foam brush for this, good and saturated with paint. And I'll show you, when I used just a bristle brush for the base layer, and there's a reason why I wanted it to have some texture to it, because a lot of times when you use a sponge brush, it comes out very smooth, and I wanted it to have a little bit of texture to it. Telling me to put more paint?
No, I'm saying you might want to mention bubbles.
Bubbles? Oh.
Around the edges?
Oh, yeah, the bubbles around the edges really don't matter because you're not even.
The bubbles, now if you do have bubbles in the center where the you're making your stencil, if you have bubbles where you're making your stencil, you can have some issues. So you want to make sure your vinyl is smooth where you're putting your paint. Okay. So there we go. Now that is just a light layer of black. Again, I don't want it too perfect. I want it to kind of have that worn farmhouse like you found it in a 100-year-old house. So there we go. Now we're going to let this dry and then we'll show you how to remove the stencil. Okay, so I let the, okay, where are we going?
Yeah.
Okay, so I left the paint on here for about 15 minutes. I didn't want to leave it too long because to me it's a little bit harder to get crisp lines whenever you're letting your paint dry too long. So what we're doing right now is just removing all of the excess vinyl. Okay. It's okay because we're going to put wax over that. I need it. Okay, so I went ahead and mixed up the antique in wax, which this is Art Minds antique wax. And what you're supposed to do is it's going to age the Lazy Susan. There we go. And it seals and protects it. Okay. Yep. That's the hard part about working with the Lazy Susan is it does spin. Okay, let's add a little bit more. Kind of like staining. Okay. Okay. Let's hold it like this. There we go. That's a little bit better. And see how it matches the texture of where I had the paint? And once this is set for 48 hours, you clean it with a cloth and it is ready to go and ready to be used. Let me put a little bit. Just around the outside. And you can use this a little bit more sparingly than what I am. You can use different colors. This one is a dark brown. They do make other colors besides just this shade. There. Gotta find a way to hold it so I can rub the wax in without it sitting there moving. Maybe it was worth the money just so I didn't have to sit here and hold it. There we go. And you don't have to use chalk paint. Chalk paint is just what I decided to use. You can use regular paint. Just kind of depends on the look that you're going for. There we go. Now I love how this came out. Look how cute that is. And roughly for the paint, which those are about $9 each, but you can buy them all the time for 50%. Let me hold it so you can see it. For 50% off at Hobby Lobby or Michael's. So that's $18 worth of paint. The brushes were cheap. And then the Lazy Susan was $10. Even if it was just that, it's still half the cost of what it was at the Nutcracker Market. And if you're using it multiple times, it's a whole lot cheaper than that. Now, once this is all good and dry, we'll take and clean it with a cloth. And the more you use it, this wax will wear off. It's not always going to stay that dark. But where my fingers went. But I hope that y'all like this video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button right down below. And if you hit the notification bell icon next to it, that will notify you when we post new videos, which for Craftmas is every single day of the month, all the way up until December 21st. Don't forget to check me out on all my social medias, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, as well as my second channel, which is just Betsy Gocher, which is all things makeup and a little bit of everything else. So I think that's it, and we'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.